A main cause of failed reeds is an unstable tip opening that is constantly collapsing on you. Not only does a proper internal bevel create a strong and counterbalanced tip opening, but you can vary the underlying pitch tendencies of your reed by making small changes to the bevel. A fulcrum provides tension by using force on one side of a lever to create movement on the other side. Here is a drawing of a standard bevel. Notice that there are two variables, the length and the depth. The internal bevel is a fulcrum, and by changing the length and depth of the bevel, we can change the position and size of the fulcrum. But how does this affect the pitch tendencies of a reed? This blank was made with an extremely long and shallow bevel for demonstration purposes. Notice what happens when I clip the tip of this blank. Notice how closed the tip is. So because my tip openings are a consistent size, I need to open up the reed quite a bit. In order to do that, I need to round the first wire and possibly the second. Okay, so that's what my tip opening looks like now. Observe how round the tube is after doing that. It's really important to remember that the transition from ellipse, your mouth, to circle, the bore of the bassoon, needs to be unbroken. The second wire always needs to be rounder than the first, even if it's only slightly. Now, on the other end of the spectrum, this blank was made with an extremely short and deep bevel for demonstration purposes. Notice what happens when I clip the tip of this blank. Notice how open the tip is. So because I need that consistent tip opening size, I need to close this reed down a lot. And in order to do that, I need to flatten the first wire and possibly the second. Now observe how flat the tube is after correcting the tip opening. This wire chart shows how you can affect a reed by changing the shape of the wires, or the tube. Looking at intonation, we can see that a rounder tube favors sharp tendencies, i.e. sharp notes are even sharper, in-tune notes are slightly sharper, and flatter notes are closer to in tune. And a flatter tube favors flat tendencies, i.e. flat notes are even flatter, in-tune notes are slightly flatter, and sharper notes are closer to in tune. So, to make a reed sharper, make a longer, shallower bevel, and to make a reed flatter, make a shorter, deeper bevel. These demonstration bevels are extreme for purposes of clarity, so a standard bevel is sufficient for most reed making, and even small adjustments can have a really big impact. A standard bevel is about 3/8 of an inch long and less than 1 millimeter deep. Remove the cotton string from your mummy. And then cut off your wire. You just cut the twist off and then it, the rest of it unwraps very easily. Open up your reed, dust off the inside. If you have any markings that you need to transfer to the outside, you can do that now. You can use either a file or sandpaper to make the internal bevel. I'll show both. First, however, I'm going to mark 3/8 of an inch to make absolutely sure that I'm not going to bevel too deeply. I'm also going to be checking constantly to make sure that I'm not going too far down. This is a 3/8 inch flat diamond file. You can also use your regular 3-square diamond file that you use for scraping, or a heavier grit sandpaper. This is 220. Okay. Place the file as flat as possible, not squeezing the cane together or spreading it apart, but simply holding it and going back and forth. You don't have to push very hard. Looking good. I'd like to do a little bit more. It doesn't quite hold the tip opening as far open as I'd like. Nice. This is where the eventual tip opening of the reed is going to be. You can see that it pops open nicely when the bevel is being cinched down by that third wire, second wire, first wire. And the other side looks the same. Now I'm going to do one with sandpaper, holding my fingers, first finger and thumb, at the markings so that I don't go too far. Again, I'm being careful not to spread the cane apart by pushing down or squeeze the cane together. I'm just simply holding it at the markings and going back and forth. Taking a sharp bevel to its extreme, we would end up with a reed with an overly round tube that is very inflexible, very stuffy, too sharp in the sharpest tending notes and with no low register at all. If we took a flat bevel to its extreme, we would have an overly flat tube that is very unstable and weak, too free-blowing, very flat on flat tending notes, and with no high register to speak of. So, as a principal bassoonist of an orchestra that plays at 442, I have to make a variety of changes to my setup to balance out all the factors. I cannot rely on internal bevel alone. I personally make an internal bevel that is slightly longer, maybe closer to half an inch, and a tiny bit shallower. But I also play on a number one bocal, and I have moved the wires on my shape to make a slightly narrower reed. All these changes together allow me to play comfortably in the solo register, but still have flexibility and strength and a good overall resonance. If I played second bassoon in an ensemble that tuned to 440, I might make a shorter, deeper bevel to favor flatter tendencies, to favor the low register because that is where I will spend most of my time and energy, and to be more free-blowing. Now, why can't you just make a reed with a rounder or flatter tube? Why do you even need a bevel? These reeds have been made with no internal bevel, but I have made the tubes comparably round and flat. Notice that the tip opening of the round tube is extremely open, and since we have chosen to not flatten the wires, this would require a lot in the way of scraping in the channels and near the spine to achieve the ellipse shape of the tip opening. This would weaken the reed considerably, perhaps irredeemably. Notice that the tip opening of the flat tube is extremely closed, and since we have chosen not to round the wires, it would require much in the way of scraping on the rails in order to achieve the proper tip opening. This reed would be unbearably stuffy and unresponsive. So, why do we make this internal bevel? Aside from the benefits of having a counterbalanced and strong tip opening, we can affect the overall pitch tendencies of our reeds without warping the blades and tip opening out of an initial workable shape. ¶¶